Hello, this is Robbie Robertson, and this is the first time. It originates on the Six Nation Indian Reserve, where my mom was born and raised. It seemed like all my relatives there, everybody played an instrument. Everybody played a mandolin or a fiddle or hand drums, all something like that. And at a very young age, I thought, how do I get into this club? And so they said, well, what instrument do you think you would like to play? I said the wrong thing. I said, well, I've seen lots of cowboys playing guitar, you know, in movies and everything. I think I'd like to play guitar. And they're like, cowboys? We're Indians. So anyway, everybody had a laugh. And pretty soon I had a guitar on my lap and they were teaching me, you know, put your fingers here and put your fingers there. So we had signed on to play with Bob Dylan, and it was the first time that I ever played with him at Forest Hills, New York. We weren't that well informed of what was going on, of this thing between folk music and rock and roll and his transitional thing that was going on. Who cares? What's the big deal? Somebody wants to experiment in music and do something different than what they did before. Well, I found out what the big deal was. We played and people were charging the stage in anger and the police were grabbing them and it was like, holy moly, this is like a revolt going on here. And all Bob's could say about it is, whatever you do, don't stop playing. Just no matter what happens, just keep going, you know? And so we did, and I just thought, that's really strange. Little did I know that this was gonna be going on for months and months and months, eventually around the world. It's hard to get used to something like that, but I actually did. Rick Danko, he tracked down this place. He found this place, and when I went in to that ugly pink house and went down in that basement, I said, this is it. This is the place. And I could see it. We'll set the organ up over here. The drums can go there. We can put the mics in here. I had the whole vision in it. And it became the sanctuary and the place that so much music came out of there. It was the beginning of the band finding what we were looking for. When the band played at Woodstock, we had only played one or two jobs as the band before that. And now we were going out in front of 500,000 people at 9 o'clock at night on the last night of the festival. And they were ready to go crazy and rock. And they'd been out in the mud and the rain, and they just wanted to do whatever they were doing more. And you could feel this vibe coming off the audience. And you look down, and there's people with their arms in the air and their shirts off, and yeah. And we went out, and the music we played was equivalent to performing hymns. It wasn't, let's go crazy, let's rock, let's rip our shirts off. It wasn't that at all. You saw the whole audience just kind of settle into this zone, and they just tripped out with us on this music while we played. We left, and they went right back to ripping their shirts off and pouring the mud on. As we settled for becoming the band and we're recording this first album, Music from Big Pink, we did not have a barometer for thinking about hit records. What we were really obsessed with was, can we just make some music that we're really proud of? So when we made our first record, in this song, The Weight was on there. Take a load off, Penny. Take a load for free. It started to become quite popular. And then finally, they told me, everybody is covering this song, from Aretha Franklin, the Staple Singers, the Temptations, and Diane. It was just on and on. Jackie DeShannon, they just kept naming off names. And finally, I remember this day that Albert Grossman said to me, there's 35 people around the world that have recorded this song. This is what you call a standard. And I felt pretty proud of that. My ex road manager, John Taplin, produced Mean Streets. And he said, oh my God, you gotta see this. He said, I think this director might be a talented guy. And there's this actor in it. His name is Bobby De Niro. He said, we really think he's got something special too. I went to a screening, I saw Mean Streets, and I thought, this is the beginning of something very, very special. And when I came out of the screening, Marty was there, and he just came by to say hello. And I was like, whoa, this movie, this going inside that world and the performances and everything and the music, oh my God. And I was so thrilled about his work. A while later, I asked him if he would direct The Last Waltz. The first time I met Eric Clapton was at a friend's house in Los Angeles. And it was after music from Big Pink came out. He was such a kind, lovely guy. And I admired him, you know, and musically. I thought he was so gifted. We were introduced and he said, you know, this record of yours, I've been telling people all over about this record. He said, I had one of the first acetates of it. And it affected me so strongly that I've decided I'm breaking up Cream. I'm leaving Cream. And I said, whoa, wait a minute. I kind of like Cream. I don't want that responsibility. And he said, too late.